wiped out real fast by Tamiris. She really just didn't hold anything back. Obviously, the Australians lost their colonial empire over North America. Weirdly, this is just where Germany has all their focus. They're pretty much not going to exist in Europe anymore. They'll just have this part of their empire forever, I think. Again, the revolts in this part of the world. You gotta give these people credit. I mean, they were fighting for their freedom the entire time. Even in the 27th century, these are the 10 leaders that are still alive, which, I mean, they should be proud. A lot of other places can't say that same thing. But it's really just between the Congo, Scythia, maybe Germany, but not really. The Venetians were actually wiped out by the Ottomans, so they are the ultimate Middle Eastern civ, I guess. They got no colonies either. I don't think they have anything outside of, like, this core empire. I would assume that maybe Scythia would continue off towards North America. It'd be very easy to do some naval invasions on the west coast and slowly take over this continent, but at the same time, Frederick still has a lot of units. That would be pretty bloody. I actually want to say that maybe even Germany has a better military than the Congo. I mean, they kind of don't have as many robots. I'm not sure that matters. We definitely have at least one edgelord out there. They're proposing that the world ideology be turned to communism. Tasty. There's a nice little event trying to fix climate. I'm pretty sure it is way too late for that, guys, but, I mean, have fun. Global CO2 contributions are pretty mixed, for the most part, kind of. Australia, the Zulu, and really Phoenicia, just kind of trapped in the South Pole. I don't know how this is possible. I didn't even think this was a thing, but Scythia's running completely off of natural energy. How the hell did they do that? And I just love looking at this. This is such a long list now because it has everything. There we go. Oh my god. Category 5 hurricane killed 19. That's a new record. Haven't seen that before. Crippling blizzard in America killed 16 and 52 damage tiles. Oh man, that probably hit Germany too. Maybe that's what crippled their empire. I forgot that the sea level wasn't really going to change because none of these earth maps have ice tiles, which are required to melt. I mean, they have snow tiles, but the ice is what causes water to go up and take up other tiles. Maybe in the future, something will be updated and we'll get to see more of that. In terms of religion, Catholicism remains on top by one single city. They have 60 cities, Hindu has 59. Oh, wow, I'm dumb. Okay, obviously, the numbers wouldn't stay the same. Judaism now kind of dominates. How is that possible? Who did this? It's gotta be Scythia and the Congo. Did they win? I didn't even check on this. I just assumed that they were obviously all dead. No, this is actually the world's most dominant religion. It's pretty much just the New World and Western Europe that is following Catholicism. But, I mean, yeah, I had no idea that Africa would eventually just spread their faith. Some of that stuff even made it down here towards Australia and New Zealand. They're split, but, yeah, no longer worshipping their Outback Steakhouses. This shouldn't be a surprise, but I still wanted to show it off. I mean, it is still kind of shocking just to see the Ottomans with 7 capitals under their control. There are currently no wars going on, and very few alliances. I guess there's just one. The UN is Kube, so yeah, that's it. In terms of governments, I guess the edgelord happened to be the Ottomans. They are communist.
stupid idea. I've tried so hard to resist it. I've tried so hard to ignore it. It's finally going to happen. And no, I'm not talking about this. This will have to wait. I don't even want to do this. I'm talking about doing my first ever conversion video. One save between two different games. Victoria 2 to Hearts of Iron 4. We're doing a big old save game. That's why this video is super long. I can't believe I'm doing this shit. So we're focusing on America, and what if they participated in the scramble for Africa? Much more than just Liberia. We'll talk about Liberia, but what if they had their own big-ass colony? Many people consider Liberia to be kind of a United States African colony, but that's not what's going to happen here today. They're going to be taking massive portions of land for themselves, which means France and the UK may be a little bit weaker here. The extra competition, I'm sure, will not be welcomed. Relations are probably not going to be that good. So then, as I said, we're going all the way up to World War II, and I can only imagine how drastically that whole thing's going to change. One thing that I'm actually excited for is I didn't realize how good the converter is. Like, taking a game from Vicky 2 to Boy 4 is just going to be a whole different experience. Victoria 2 actually does a great job of giving us some backstory. Like, no one's going to be taken over the planet in this game, but it will tell us why certain countries are doing better than others before we take the Hearts of Iron. Now, before everyone starts asking me, I don't think I can ever do a CK2 game to Hoi 4 game, like a 1,000-plus-year timeline. Things get so crazy in that, like, the map is going to look disgusting. This is going to be relatively realistic. What I'm saying is, it's not like we're going to see people from the North Pole take over, like, half the planet. We're starting off with the Texas War for Independence, and, this doesn't intend to go well for Mexico. The Americans are probably going to get involved. We also have two minor conflicts taking place in South America, and then Spain is fighting Morocco, just as they normally do. Obviously, Prussia should be uniting Germany at some point in this video, but from there, we'll have to see how, you know, the whole Great War goes. That can go pretty bad for them, especially afterwards if they lose and they let painters leave their country. Now, this is something we're going to be looking at quite often in the Victoria part of this video. The UK right now is number one in the world, France number two. And the US will probably get pretty high as soon as the whole imperialization thing starts happening. Something we've got to talk about, as the Prussians actually just formed the North German Federation, is, and actually before I say it, keep in mind, obviously I'm a fucking idiot, so I don't know exactly what I'm saying. Basically, there's a sphere of influence thing where major countries try to influence minor countries. So, like, for instance, we got two Sicilies, they just became part of the sphere of influence for France. And I believe that means they can get called into a war. Something like that. But the important thing here is that whenever we take the save to Hoi 4, whoever is in the sphere of influence will be a part of that same faction. So right now, Japan is technically under the American sphere of influence. That is definitely not going to stay the same. But yes, I said that...
Martin's got field cannons.
They technically would have been a part of the same alliance if we were to take it to Hearts of Iron right now. Ouch. Okay. By 1856, Mexico has been left with just their normal territory and Arizona, which is actually just a big-ass desert, so you probably don't even want that. And at the moment, there's this thing called the United States of Central America, which I really, really like. I hope it doesn't break apart, because this is convenient. El Salvador is just kind of chilling here, kind of doing their own thing, though. Okay, maybe they're going fascist already. Of course, any ideology that gets adopted and established by certain countries in Vicky 2 will get converted over to Hoi 4. And obviously that's going to be a major deal in that game. Oh, beautiful. Karl Marx just wrote his little fantasy novel. Fantasy novel, because it could never work in real life. Communist Manifesto. Alright. And I think the UK is starting to feel it. Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Oh, I can already hear the banjos. The banjos and all the statues getting put up. Problem with the CSA is they almost never win. Yeah, and it looks like they're probably not going to win this time either. Yeah, I don't even know how they're supposed to win. I don't see any sort of divisions or regiments, whatever they're called in this game. Okay, yeah, they're dead. I guess one way they can get their independence is if they just had, like, a bigger uprising. I've seen in other campaigns that get, like, New Mexico and Nebraska, Kansas, all the way up on their side. If they had more states, they'd probably do better. And here we go. Here's the beginning of the scramble for Africa. The U.S. getting their first colony right still seemed fine. Italy also just warmed up, and actually, so did Scandinavia. Also, Helvetia 2 technically doesn't have an observer mode. This was back during a time where Paradox knew it would just be cancerous to include. I'm using Bhutan to view. I'm hoping that I won't get the kills. If they can somehow make it through this entire video, I'll feel pretty good. I don't know what this is, but once again, we have now a North German Austrian Brothers War. Not exactly sure what that means, but Germans aren't looking too good. Which is interesting, because technically they're still fourth in the rankings in terms of greatest powers. The US have jumped all the way to third. That's pretty great. And now the Spanish have begun to colonize the Middle East, grabbing parts of Egypt and the Arabian Peninsula. Also, the British just grabbed the Suez. I believe any great power could have got it. I've seen the French take it once. Of course, AI Persia loves torturing us in this game. Their borders look just unreasonable. It's not even about looking ugly. Like, how are we supposed to manage this? And it happens. It happens. Of course, the Americans bought just the entire Russian colony. I was really hoping they would just keep that. I guess not this time around, though. And Austria is now starting to do quite a bit of damage to Germany, I think. I mean, they've won multiple wars against them. Now they're starting to take some land away.
Still don't want a piece out.
Also, it's technically April 1900, and Germany still hasn't unified this region just yet. That could be bad. American Africa is looking good, though. They have a huge portion of this continent, maybe the biggest so far. Yeah, definitely. I mean, a lot of their territory is Sahara Desert, so we can do with that. But it is much bigger than the French and British territories. And I'm thinking my prediction might start coming true. This is the opinion map mode for the U.S. A lot of people don't like them.
Could have
peaced
out, but no.
The big one. France does, so that's interesting. And Austria as well, which they're definitely a good friend to have, at least in this campaign. But I think the most interesting part of this alternative history is still yet to come. With the U.S. having all this territory really close to Europe, where, you know, the shit tends to go down, World War II is going to be real good. Also, I believe the Chinese have been smoking some opium for the last, I don't know if you smoke opium, whatever you do with opium. They've been doing that for, like, a couple decades. Civil War, I believe, is about to break out. Well, it's kind of already starting to. Damn, Russia. Okay, that's messed up. Taking a nice chunk out of Scandinavia, specifically Norway. As for the rest of Europe, which, keep in mind, this stuff changes fairly quickly. Clearly, the Ottomans have dropped out of being a major power, since they're being influenced by the British now. Oh, wow. Okay, and Russia's already thrusting their influences in northern China. This is probably how you turn commie, guys. Damn it. Okay, well, I've been referring to World War II as basically the stage in this game when we take it to Toy 4. I don't think that's kind of the case. This is the second Great War in this universe, and it's 1903. Once again, it's the UK and Germany teaming up, this time with the help of Italy. Be careful, they change sides. And Bavaria versus Austria, France, and the US. It's actually not looking too good for this team. I guess I kind of completely missed World War I. My bad. Well, here's World War II, I guess. And we're still doing their own thing. They're still getting more powerful. Wow, they just took all of Korea. And they're not wasting their time in one massive war. Oh my god. And we already have our first major nation that adopted communism. Who knows when it was. North Germany. Congratulations. We still gotta see if they keep this. Also, Spain continuing to spread their influences in the Arabian Peninsula. Not bad. It's looking pretty good. Also, migration is actually pretty interesting to look at. Obviously, the U.S., I think, is getting the most immigrants, which actually includes that territory of Africa they now control. Well, it looks like the Chinese Empire have handled their little civil war. They're actually looking quite terrifying. Also, somehow Korea got their independence. What is this going to stop? How many damn great wars are going to happen? Do you guys just, they just love killing people? Okay, well, just so we know, when we go to World War 4, technically that's going to be World War 5. This is normal. Regardless, it looks like we're not going to see like a unified German region. We have three different powers: Russia, the North German Federation.
Check out the new Lego Human Design multiplayer experience.
And Bavaria. It's a bit divided still. Bomb colony. Well, there you go. With the competition for colonies constantly increasing as European nations scramble for Africa. Wow, this is amazing. So the U.S. basically could do the best African colony. Maybe they should have done this all along. But then again, you know, I believe
over number one in the Great Powers list before. I don't know about any more, though. I like what you're doing, Italy, but at the same time, come on, man. This is horrible. Why did you take this part of France? And also, just before we take the Save the Hoi 4, I just like to add that I'm probably going to get rid of these tiny Indian nations. They're part of the British sphere anyway, so it doesn't matter. So here it is. Game's over. 100 momentous years have passed, but we can still take one more look at the rankings. That's what I thought. That is exactly what I thought. But the German Empire isn't too far ahead of the U.S. They're going to be pretty even, I think, in Hearts of Iron. Italy managed to just squeeze their way into the Great Powers, just like they did in real life. Also, just like in real life, I believe they're fascists as well. Damn! Okay, I just figured out how to easily see who's fascist and communist. A lot of very minor places have gone the fascist route. Italy being obviously the biggest one, though. Communism is much weaker, on the other hand, but, you know, it's all good, because they've got the greatest military threat of all. It's the British Kryptonite. If they ever step out of line, you better believe Zulu shields and sticks are going to be thrown at them. So here's our Victoria 2 map in Hearts of Iron 4. It is really nice to just zoom all the way out, but the fact that you can't zoom all the way out to, it makes me want to kill myself. So I think it's finally about time we take Hoi 4 into the super sexy cinematic view. There's actually a lot of things going on in this map. Let's take a slightly deeper look. I mean, first of all, the U.S. is just super dominant right now. No one's going to threaten them, especially in the Western Hemisphere. They might possibly lose their African colonies, though. And even though Germany's number one in the world, they're going to need to find some friends. Luckily, Russia and China are both just chilling here. While unfortunately, Japan is going to be kind of stuck by themselves. They will get the aid of Korea. That's not an annexed Korean peninsula, but that's all they really have. But no matter what happens, I think the British are kind of screwed. They're really in a tough spot. Whoever comes out on top between France and Germany, I think is easily going to be able to take over the British Isles. Okay, back to normal viewing so my computer doesn't crash, like, every 3 seconds. Yeah, the Americans also have the help of this Central American nation. Also, funny enough, El Salvador, the country I joked about being fascist a little bit earlier, yep, they would. They would. And they're, like, one of only 5 countries in the entire world that actually chose this ideology. But on the opposite end of the spectrum, we have Italy, which, as I said, went fascist. We all know what that means. It's the man, the myth, the legend. A legend that I think recently changed his name. Bada bang, Benito, welcome back. I'm pretty disappointed that Hirohito isn't here. I feel like he should be. But at the same time, I guess there's still a chance. I mean, Japan is dealing with a lot of ideologies right now. Oh yeah, this is also super important. It's probably the first thing I should have shown, but the United States have 184 factories, UK have 201, Germany has 231. So yeah, they are leading the world right now, as they should be, I guess. But the one thing FDR does have over them, which I guess this is FDR, is military. 258 divisions. Yeah, that is super high for right now. And also don't forget, they're now getting all these resources from their new African territory. Or it's not really new. The Slayer's time is now. Here's gotta be China. I'm really worried about them. They're sitting here with 6 million manpower, and I mean, whoever gets them on their team is gonna be super lucky. What's happening with Colombia? They're the only nation, I think, with this radical ideology. What is that? Libertarian political class? Okay, which advocates the state? Okay. So, like, Walmart rules their country. Afghanistan has started the first conflict in 44. They're going after a much weaker neighbor to the east. No, wait, I'm stupid. Okay, that was the north. I was thinking of somebody else. This actually might not be too easy. And then we also have Bolivia versus Peru, which Bolivia is democratic, Peru is fascist, so I don't think they're going to be getting a whole lot of help. I mean, maybe from just Mussolini's competent twin brother. Oh, speaking of the devil, there he is. Imagine, though, like, imagine if, like, he has one of the best games ever, and this university could be, like, a fucking genius. Damn. And, you know, he might actually have a chance here against Portuguese Jose Diaz. This dude only has 3 gonna do it. Crazy bastard. I love this world.
Well, an already struggling fascist ideology just lost another member. I don't even know how many they have at this point. Now Italy's invading off the coast of Africa to take the Portuguese colonies out this way. I don't know what happened to this nation in Mickey 2, but it must have been bad. It's like they have no military.
Damn it, Germany! Well, there goes all the fun. I guess they're trying to restore the HRE.
You know, they kind of already had it. And China's now invading the equivalent to Vietnam in this world. Should be a very easy pickup. I mean, they're so powerful. Okay, wait a second. Latvia just did some crazy-ass Pokemon evolution. Somehow Latvia became Polish Lithuania. How does that work? I was wrong. Okay, I was wrong once again. No surprise here. I thought this might be competent Benito. It ended up being just regular Benito. No, I'm just kidding. Germany's super powerful. They've got a bunch of divisions. 316 factories at the moment. Luckily for France, though, I mean, it's not going to be that good, but they were given a big alliance, so that will help. How are the Ottomans doing? So we have this, like, Saudi portrait that we're kind of used to seeing. They've got two puppets, actually, in Europe, surprisingly. They're not a great power, so I'm assuming they're struggling. Yeah, definitely, factory-wise, they're not doing too good. Wait a second, did the Americans just get rid of Liberia? Yeah, you can't... Okay, this was meant to be a very different thing. Yeah, this is a bad combination. Very, very bad combination. It seems like the democracies are in the lead, but we have Germany, Russia, and China all following the same ideology. Which, by the way, just for anybody wondering, this is a form of monarchy in which one ruler has supreme authority. It's kind of self-explanatory. And then there's also Mexican Franco. Mexican Francisco Franco. Does he remember in the very beginning, in like 1836, when he controlled Arizona? Wouldn't you want that again? Actually, did they have a claim? No claim? Really? Oh, yes they do. Oh my god. Their flags changed, so I didn't see it at first. And here we go. Alright, this actually might be the beginning of World War V. Yeah, World War V. Jesus. This is going to be a disaster. There's just no way they can survive. I don't see a scenario where Japan or Korea don't get their booty kicked. And just to check, you know, China still has somewhat okay army composition, which is surprising. Although they could just get rid of everything else and probably just stick to these. Well, you guys just messed up. You guys just messed up real bad. France declared war on Russia. We'll see if Scandinavia wants to join. I seriously doubt it. Because that's what happens. That is exactly what happens. And actually, that's what should happen. Whenever Germany has, you know, smart rulers in charge. Damn! Okay, they even got the Ottomans to just join. Okay, this is going to be tough. I don't care how much territory the Americans have. This is not looking good. Wow. Okay. France, just go ahead and bend over. You might as well. I mean, they're being supported by, of course, Great Britain and...
Growing up, Shasty.
That probably...
I'm good, man. I guess that's how I'm going to buy it.
Scandinavia is smart. Scandinavia is real smart. They're just going to stay out of it. They don't care if they're supposed to help out. Just don't do it. And, of course, GB is just going to make things way, way worse. China's definitely joining the alliance of Germany now. Well, I don't know. Let's see. There's a chance they don't. Also, Japan just got Burma on their side, as if that's going to save them. Once again, the Americans are also trying to help out British Raj, but it's really not going to help. They're going to need to actually get involved here. And they're getting involved. Okay, yet they are actually getting involved. I know I told you to do it, but why the fuck would you listen to me? So France is going to get taken out by Germany. That is very clear. Hopefully Scandinavia somehow escapes their fate. And a lot of democracies, basically Britain, Japan's not a democracy, and the U.S. are all attacking China. Oh, that's what this is. I was wondering the whole time, like, what this Congo nation was. It's a puppet to Scandinavia. It went communist. Okay.
Advanced seminar